Hey everyone, this is the third day of a week of awesomeness.
A week of awesomeness.
I've got the melody right. In which I give you one video every day for 5 days straight. They can be found in the playlist if you've missed any of the previous ones. If you hear builders in the background, it's because they're banging away at the wall next door. Anyway, can't help that. Today's topic is Today's topic is, can anyone lucid dream? Now, it's a bit interesting. I get this in my inbox quite a bit, saying that I don't think I can lucid dream. Can you help me? Blah, blah, blah. I don't think I'm susceptible for lucid dreaming. I don't think blah, blah, blah. I don't think blah, blah. Let me stop you there. Everyone can lucid dream. That's the thing. Anyone can train their brain to know that they're lucid dreaming. I don't know this for definite. I don't know if that's a definite fact, but using some crude logic, I can guess that, yeah, everyone can lucid dream. There are a few people, however, that make them more susceptible to lucid dreaming. They're usually the more creative people, you know, music writers, actors, people like that. And also, recent studies have shown that when a person in my generation, so I'm 20 years old, person in my generation who plays a lot of video games, like Final Fantasy or something, just like me, are more susceptible to lucid dreaming. And they give, again, a crude logic to this. They say that they're used to being immersed in a dream world, in a fake reality, and they know that they're conscious because they're the player. They're conscious, separate to the person in the game. There are a few things that you need to do in order to lucid dream. A few things are increase your dream recall by increasing your vividness in a dream, and you can do that by writing down your dreams and then analysing your dreams as you go along. As I said before, at the introduction of the Week of Awesomeness, you don't have to have a dream journal, you can have a dream audio tape in which you just talk to the tape and listen back in the morning, which is a good tip. Wish I had that tip. That's what she said. Anyway, this is what happens when it's unscripted and unedited. You get long gaps of plainness where I forget what I was talking about. More people are susceptible to lucid dreaming. That is true. But it doesn't necessarily mean that you don't lucid dream. That not everyone can lucid dream. As long as you dream, you can lucid dream. There are, however, a few medical reasons that you can't lucid dream. You physically cannot lucid dream. I don't know if they're real, but in Prison Break, the TV show, which is awesome, by the way, there was a character called Haywire, and as Michael was carving the wall, he turned around and Haywire was just staring at him from the top bunk of his prison cell, and he said, "What are you doing? Go to sleep." He says, "I got a blah, 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 blah in my brain. I can't sleep." And Michael's like, "Oh, no." I think his name's, Michael Scofield, isn't it? So, I don't know if that's real, but he doesn't sleep. And if you don't sleep, then you don't lucid dream. Again, another thing that makes it more pertinent for people is that if you don't lucid dream, if you don't have a regular sleeping pattern, then your dream cycles are shifted and you won't be in REM sleep, which gives you the most lucid dreaming time. I'll talk more about dream cycles in a few videos. But yeah, you need to dream, you need to write down your dream, which is increasing your vividness and dream recall. Then you've got to use reality checks in order to lucid dream. That's it. Well, I hope you enjoyed this. It's been very fun for me, standing in a cold room, looking at a camera, talking to myself. If people walk in now, they think I'm Gollum, the starlet from us, my precious Gollum. But I'm not, so. Anyway, that's that. Check the playlist if you've missed any of the previous Week of Awesomeness, and I'll see you tomorrow for the fourth day of Week of Awesomeness.
Bye!